Some of you may be actually moving and transferring your whole life. I mean, it may be a complete whole new world, new city, new state, new country. But Virgos, you're successful all the way along the way and really feeling empowered and confident along this journey. And you're going to get a pleasant surprise of this news. And I really believe it has to do with a new cycle, a new door opening up, having to do with the Six of Wands, whatever. Hi, Virgos. Good morning, good day, and good afternoon, darlings. Yes, this is my second time filming this. I finished a reading and it did not record, so you just have to trust that I shuffled on camera and all these things happened. Anyway, we're going to get right to it. If you're new to my channel, my name is Amanda. Welcome to the High Vibe Tribe. If you're a subscriber or returning viewer, know that I thank you so much for the love and support. If you want to be a part of this collective energy, definitely hit that subscribe bell and button so that you can be a part of this energy exchange between you darlings and me. And also don't forget to give me a thumbs up. So we're going to get right to it. I have three piles here. I'm going to show you the doorway card. So this is going to be doorway number one, or pile one, pile two, or doorway number two, and number three. Doorway three, pile three. So pick a number, one, two, or three. You may be drawn to more than one, and that's fine. Stay tuned at the end and we'll go over those. So I'm gonna put these aside for now. Again, this is pile number one, pile number two, and pile number three. So we'll get to those at the end. So when I was doing your reading, Virgos, what was showing up energetically and what's here is that you're having this really successful time in your life. There's some kind of accomplishment that you are achieving. So whether this is actually like a school or a certificate, there's some kind of level up. Something that you've wanted for a very long time is going to be presented to you, meaning that you're going to get your flowers. You're going to get your accolades. There's something here about it really satisfying your younger self, the younger version of you, with this accomplishment here. So this tells me that it's something here that, again, you've wanted for a long time, you've worked really hard for. I feel like the Virgos I'm speaking to as well have done a lot of letting go, releasing, trusting more in the process, trusting more in the universe, trusting more in source and spirit and God, and just going with the flow a lot more than what you did in the past. The World card is here. This is all about new cycles. I feel like this opportunity, whatever you're being recognized for, placed on a podium, maybe given an advancement, a new job, something like that. Whatever this is in this accomplishment is going to open the doors for this whole new world. It's like whatever you've been working really hard for is going to allow for all these doors to open for this brand new cycle. The world is all about a new cycle beginning. This is just the start with this acknowledgement. This is just the start with you letting go into this whole new world. I mentioned earlier about you your inner child, your inner self is going to be really proud of where you are at and the accomplishments that you made. And I think it just is something you've wanted since a young age for some of you. You're moving forward with a lot of inspired action, with a lot of creativity. I feel like you're just moving in a different purpose, in a different way. A lot of Aries, Leo, Sag here, Virgos. And then it's like something has finally paid off. So we have you moving forward and trusting the universe more, letting go and just going with the flow a lot more. And we have the Seven of Pentacles here. And this is like, okay, some of my fruits have ripened, but not all of them. And so this is a waiting. And you've been waiting for this world, for this cycle to start to open up for you. And it's here now. So that's just a really beautiful thing. The other thing is, as I did pull clarifiers, I'm just going to reshuffle that part, but I did pull clarifiers and the original message really was about you getting over a lot of heartbreak, a lot of kind of, you know, negative emotions, going through quite a bit. The Six of Wands is a really big deal. You've had to travel from really rough situations into a calmer one, and you've created this new version for yourself. You've created this new accomplishment. You've created this new job, business, whatever, because you did the work to achieve it. And so it's like you came from this really rough place and now you are here feeling much more settled, much more free. After a time of pretty much a lot of heartbreak and pain. And Virgos, what do you need to know? Tell us about the Six of Wands. Yeah, you're really successful. I think you've come from a lot of heartbreak, a lot of not having really true connections. And it looks like that's going to be something that you're going to have on the horizon if you're not already in a very deep relationship. It doesn't have to be a relationship with someone that you're intimate with, but it could just be relationships in general. Like you really are finding trust in a situation. And that goes along with this letting go. I think it's a lot of self-love too. Like I said in your other clarifiers, it was about you moving from harsh environments into this brand new calmer water, calmer situation, getting over a lot of heartbreak. And so now you're seeing the fruits of your labor pay off and you're emotionally fulfilled. You're emotionally full. This is a really different energy than where you were. So that's the Virgos I'm speaking to, because the Virgos I'm speaking to have been through it. Let me just say, to have the Two of Cups here is just, it's just beautiful. If you are looking for a love connection, you most definitely could be having success in the person that you're talking with or you're seeing. It could be a really good deep connection for you to move forward in a really successful relationship. Okay, that's too many. Let's get one for the Four of Pentacles in reverse. What do we need to know about the Four of Pentacles in reverse, please and thank you? Yeah, this comes after a time of feeling left out in the cold. The Pentacles is here. This actually came out when I did your reading the first time. It's long overdue that you've released a lot of things. You've released holding on to things, having to have and feeling like you can't release. It's this release, it's this trusting, it's this letting go. After a time of feeling really unbalanced, kind of put out, you know, put out, not feeling like you had the power to change your situations. And you realize that you did. You realize you have the key right here. You just weren't looking at it. Now you've turned that corner. So this trusting comes from a long time of pain, of feeling like an outcast. Perhaps some of you felt outcasted. Some of you may have lost a job and now you're in the situation where things are working out for you. I feel like some of you may have lost a job and it just wasn't for you. It wasn't meant for you. The door closed and it's like, and it's so that you could have the success in this area. I don't know. It's one of those things, and I know you hate to hear it, but like, definitely it's a time of, oh, love it. It's a time of really trusting yourself, really being the boss. Like you really took the bull by the horns. Is that the saying? You took the bull by the horns here with this Emperor in the world here, and you decided, you know what? I have everything I need to create the world that I want. I have all the power, I have all the knowledge, I have all the wisdom. And it was really about trusting yourself and letting go and trusting God as well in the universe. And you've done that. And because of that, there's this huge success that's going to be showing up for you in July or whenever you come across this reading. It's going to make you feel so fulfilled with this Two of Cups. And it's also like really going to just nourish your inner self, your inner child. This is a big deal. The Six of Wands is a big deal. This letting go and trusting is a big deal. And you've really bossed up. You're making the shots and you're being very strategic and standing in your power right now, Virgos, really standing in your power. This is coming forward at a time. Like all of this is going to be happening pretty fast. Some of you may have already been acknowledged for the good and hard work that you did. I'm super excited to hear what it is. So comment down below and let me know what it is that you accomplished. Is it a degree? Is it a certificate? Did you get it promoted? Are you starting your own business? What are you being acknowledged for? Are you a partner now and something? There's just some big deal here and we have the world again. The cycles are just changing. Things are just turning in your favor. When you trust and allow and believe and, you know, have that confidence and just when you pull yourself out from the darkness, when you transform and transmute energy, it creates this whole new cycle, and you're just with this world. It is truly like this whole new opportunity, all these doors opening for you, all this newness coming your way that is going to make you extremely happy. When I did your first reading, the sun came out, and that's the happiest card in the deck, and you are going to be one very happy, happy camper. We have the Wheel of Fortune out here twice, so this is a new cycle. This is a whole new world for you. This is a whole new beginning. After a time of feeling really bound up with your own self-doubts, with your past situations, with the past feelings, with the past life experiences, it's like you've come such a far way, and now you're moving forward in this more confident, inspired, kind of creative way of moving, and just a creative way of knowing. You've released yourself. And when you release yourself, because we have all the power within, it allows for so much to start to move and create and manifest. The Seven of Pentacles, the Tower. Yeah, I think you may be shocked when when your fruit ripens all at once. I think it's going to be a really shocking moment. We have a lot of major arcana, so that tells me this energy is happening pretty quickly for you. But this is the Tower card is a pleasant surprise in this situation and this energy. It's a pleasant surprise. This acknowledgement is going to come sooner than you think. It's going, things are going to just start moving so much faster. We have the Three of Wands. It's going to allow for you to really decide how you want to move, what that looks like for you. Where are you going? What are you going to do? Where are you traveling? I feel like for some of you too, you guys are going to be taking a trip or traveling to celebrate the Six of Wands. It's like you've done so much work. It's like you need a break. You need a few days of vacay, whether it's a staycation or an outication. Some of you may be actually moving and transferring your whole life. I mean, it may be a complete whole new world, new city, new state, new country. But Virgos, you're successful all the way along the way and really feeling empowered and confident along this journey. And you're going to get a pleasant surprise of this news. And I really believe it has to do with a new cycle, a new door opening up, having to do with the Six of Wands, whatever you accomplished. It's like there's so many opportunities. You're gonna have a lot of choices on the forefront, and you just need to decide which one is the best for you and your future and where you're headed. What else do we need to know for Virgos? What else do they need to know? Just give me a couple more cards, and then we will get into the So we have the Emperor and the Empress, Queen of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Okay. So we have a matching pair here and the Two of Cups. I have to say it and acknowledge it because it's here. Those of you who are looking for a deep connection, we have an Emperor and an Empress here. Very, very much two like-minded individuals that go hand in hand of the highest level of self-awareness. And just mindset. You guys are just going to be the yin to the yang, and it's going to be a really deep connection for those of you looking for it. This is something that is going to create and blossom into something huge. So with the Empress here and the Emperor, we have definitely a very strong pair here. Some would say a soulmate type of situation. It's a deep connection, so I'm gonna leave it at that. And it's gonna change your world. I think it's gonna take you by surprise, especially after everything that you've been through. Like I said, it's been a pretty challenging time for the Virgos I'm speaking to, so this energy is really brand new for you. Finally having things work out and pay off after a long time of putting in a lot of work and energy. You're finally seeing the rewards. You're finally in this creation mode, and it is showing up in your 3D world. You're able to see this physically, tangibly hold it, and this new cycle is just the beginning for you, like I said. So absolutely beautiful reading, Virgos. Congratulations to you. Let's get into the cards in the first pile. So the first doorway card was this doorway, and it said deeper. You are not finished. You are not yet done. Dig deeper and deeper. The best is yet to come. Hold on, hold on. Okay, your angel card was see only love. Look past the seeming errors, mistakes, and misunderstandings, and see only the love within each person, including yourself. Your resolute, focus upon the love that underlines every situation, brings about healing in undreamed of ways. Okay, this is what this is. Self-love, self-awareness. You've really gone through a lot. You've accepted kind of the way things were in the past, and you're moving forward. You're staying very present and open to what is going to be revealed for the future. Your fortune card is wish. Your heart's desire is ready to come true. I'm telling you, this is wishes are coming true for you, Virgos. This is awesome. Oh my gosh. Okay, pile number two. Doorway number two, if you pick number two, three-eyed raven. As sunrise hits upon the dew, a messenger raven calls out with news. Prepare for the unexpected. That is this tower moment, the unexpected. Prepare. It's going to take you off guard. You're going to be so shocked when you hear this. Ah, I love it. Okay, your angel card. There's nothing to worry about. You are safe and the situation is under perfect control of divine providence and universal order. Only infuse loving thoughts and emotions into the situation to ensure that the highest possible outcome flows effortlessly and through you into you. Woo! Nothing to worry about. Birth. Universal energy brings you opportunity and possibilities. Absolutely. Okay? Okay? You are birthing this whole new world. Absolutely. Possibilities and brings you absolutely so many opportunities. I told you, you have choices. The doors are opening. You can't make this up. Spirit don't lie. My energy doesn't lie. Source moves through me. And thank you so much for this gift. I'm like so blessed to have it. Anyway, pile number three, doorway number three. Three of cups. Oh, having some fun time celebrating. A toast to friendships in the afternoon sun. Three cups and happiness. Three cheers are done. A celebration is near. I am telling you. Don't say I didn't tell you so. My energy knows what it knows. All right. Your angel card. Notice the signs. Yes, the signs you've been receiving are heaven sent. We drop feathers, coins, and other signs upon your path to remind you that you're loved and never alone, darlings. And your final fortune card. Holy schmoly. Look, you are right to be strong and optimistic about the opportunities ahead. Absolutely. You worked really, really hard for this, Virgos. Congratulations. Please comment down below. Let me know what this is. What is happening? What is being birthed? What did you accomplish? What are you celebrating? Where are you going? What you doing? I want to know. And I'm just so happy to deliver this message to you. So I hope it resonated with you in some way, shape, or form. If you want to be a part of this collective energy, definitely don't forget to subscribe. Please give me a thumbs up because this is an energy exchange between you, darlings, and me. And it helps my channel out greatly, and it's super easy to do. So just hit that button. Thanks so much, and until next time, have the most fabulous day.